In Sync, Sonam's video magazine, brings you Sony products, people, and special events in the news. It's a phenomenon known as spring break. Every vernal equinox, thousands of students crowd the Florida beaches to worship the sun after a long winter. At Daytona Beach, Sony, MTV, and seven other co-sponsors introduce the vacationing crowds to the dazzling sounds of compact disc technology at Music Fest 85.
What do you think of the sound of CDs?
I think it's great. It's amazing.
Sony's D5 portable disc player and thousands of software titles were among the items on display. For all the companies involved, it was an opportunity to reach the youth market in an atmosphere conducive to music listening and having a great time.
Are you getting a lot of good response?
A lot of response. People, I think, are just knocked out by the sound, the technology, and everything that has to do with the people are just having a great time.
Most of them don't realize that there's this many discs out in the market.
What do you think about the expo? Do you think it's going pretty well?
I think it's going very well. I think that we'll probably have more kids here than we had last year, and the amazing thing is they're certainly more knowledgeable about compact discs this year than they were last, which is exactly, you know, what we wanted to accomplish.
In Daytona Beach, and all over the country, compact discs are generating new energy and excitement in the world of recorded sound. And back in New York, at Studio 54, the Sony Tape Sales Company generated some excitement of its own.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Sony Audio Tape's new cassette generation.
It was a multimedia press gala held to introduce the unique wide window design of Sony's new audio cassettes. For over three decades, Sony has been responsible for many changes and innovations in audio hardware. But the basic cassette shell design has remained unchanged for the last 20 years. Until now. John Hollins, president of Sony Tape Sales Company, gave an overview.
Now Sony, in its best creative manner, has come through again with a revolutionary new look in audio cassettes.
For the first time, precision molded wide windows allow the user to really see the tape moving as well as the remaining tape length, all at one glance. And the new radical design appears on all Sony audio cassettes. John Birmingham, Vice President of Sales and Marketing, spoke about the marketing aspects of Sony's new cassette design.
And there is no doubt that Sony's new cassette lineup has the innovative design and the marketing power to beat the other brands. Now let me introduce them once again. Miss HF. Best for vivid sound reproduction of all music sources. Miss HFS, best for enriched sound reproduction of hi-fi music. Miss UCX, best for clear and natural music reproduction. And Miss UCXS, best for high-frequency music reproduction. Miss Metal ES, best for live or digital sound reproduction.
National Association of Broadcasters Convention in Las Vegas was another major event on the Sony calendar. Three Sony companies participated in the convention, and they unveiled a wide range of exciting new products and technologies. The Sony Tape Sales Company expanded their one-inch videotape line with the new V1K series, a new step toward meeting the increasingly discriminating needs of the broadcast professional. The Professional Audio Products Division is putting microprocessors to work in their APR 5000 series of tape recorders. Advanced engineering achievements permit these recorders to be networked as a part of today's sophisticated broadcasting and music production systems. The Video Communications Division introduced their VO6800 3/4-inch video cassette recorder, the latest in the U-Matic line. Compact and lightweight, it offers significant advantages for out-of-studio production. Also on display was the Betamax Color Video Projector, a revolutionary single-lens presentation system. The Broadcast Products Company intrigued visitors to the convention with its now famous SuperMotion system. Also featured was the BVH-2500 professional video tape recorder, which won an Emmy Award this year for its still frame capabilities. Broadcast Products also added new performance dimensions to its BVP series of field and studio cameras in terms of overall mechanical design. Once again, Sony's continued devotion to technology and innovation was demonstrated at NAB. Following NAB, at a consumer video products press conference, Sony unveiled a new ultra-compact 8mm portable camera recorder named the Mini 8. Mr. Norio Oga, president of Sony, explained the Mini 8 features to about 200 members of the press.
Mini 8 uses standard 8mm cassettes, of course, with the recording capability up to 2 hours. It operates on a rechargeable battery for up to 1 hour 20 minutes.
Since the proof is in the results, he showed portions of tapes made with the Mini 8. He included scenes that he recorded on his flight from Japan. InSync took the Mini 8 outside on the streets of New York to get comments from everyday people.
Looks terrific. I can't believe this is a camera.
Well, you could take this anywhere. It's so easy. You could just take this anywhere. This is amazing.
Technology is something else, huh?
You gonna give it to me or what?
And a New York area dealer.
This is the product that everybody has been waiting for. This is really the only product that everybody's been waiting for. Finally, there is something that is convenient to utilize. Now, I have a product that I can sell to people that don't care about the equipment, that care about taking pictures. From the looks of this, and I've never seen it before, it looks extremely simple to operate and very, very easy to handle.
Meanwhile, back at the press conference, reporters expressed a great deal of interest in the beta format, especially with the introduction of Super Beta. Neil van der Dusen, president of Sony's U.S. marketing group, spoke about Super Beta's position in the marketplace.
There are three things that we believe you should know about Super Beta. First, it represents the state of the art in home video recording. A Super Beta picture is unquestionably the finest image in home recording history. Second, Super Beta isn't just for the elite or the videophile, it's, in our opinion, for everyone. When we first introduced Super Beta, speculation was that it would be only in the high-end models. However, the Betamax lineup we introduced in April proved that our commitment to Super Beta extends much farther to bring enhanced pictures and sound quality within the reach of every Beta customer. Third, Beta customers will soon enjoy Super Beta Hi-Fi pictures and sound in pre-recorded movies and music videos. Tomorrow belongs to Super Beta Hi-Fi software, and tomorrow must begin with duplication equipment for the production of that Super Beta software.
People in the news recently include John Breech, who has been named Vice President, Audio Products Division for the Consumer Products Company. Leonard Israel, who has been appointed Vice President of Planning and Control for Sony Industries. Anthony C. O'Connell, who has been appointed Vice President, Marketing for Sony Broadcast Products Company. Hisashi Sakai, who has been named President of the Sony Consumer Service Company. And Thomas E. Steckbeck, who has been promoted to Executive Vice President of the Sony Consumer Products Company.
To help celebrate Sonam's 25th anniversary in America, 25 Sonam employees were awarded a trip to Japan. Besides visiting Sony headquarters and plants, they visited Scuba Technology Exposition 85, where Sony's Jumbotron is a key attraction. Greeting the 800 Sony dealers, distributors, and Sonam employees was Mr. Masaru Ibuka, Sony's honorary chairman and deputy chairman of Expo 85. Among many feature programs shown on Jumbotron is a videotape on marine biology. Jumbotron also features a zoom-in program where visitors can wave to the screen and see themselves projected on the gigantic 82 feet high by 131 feet wide screen, the world's largest TV. In the world of finance, more than 200 representatives of the financial community attended the New York Society of Security Analysts meeting, where Sony Chairman Akio Morita reported on Sony's financial results and product innovations.
For the first quarter of 85, consolidated net sales increased 9.4% compared to last year, reflecting steady growth in the world economy, particularly in the United States.
Mr. Morita went on to speak on the status of Sony's wide range of products. He concluded by discussing Sony's efforts to boost the import of American-made goods to Japan. Sony has decided to import color picture tubes from the San Diego plant.
This is also first case that Japanese manufacturing subsidiary in this country export its product to the parent company, to Japan. So some people say Sony by Sony. So with this kind of effort as an international organization, we will continue to expand our business, and same time we will continue to keep our effort to increase our profit as a business organization and to serve our investor. Thank you very much.
And in a room in Park Ridge, New Jersey, Sony managers gathered to take part in a seminar. A seminar where fortunes are made and lost, where companies struggle in the marketplace and strategies are tested, where competition is fierce and the pressure is unrelenting. It's the Sony Management Simulation, a seminar marketed to many companies all over the world.
The Sony Management Simulation was developed in Japan in 1976, and it was developed because top management saw a need to develop some kind of practical training program in the fundamentals of how a business is actually run. And because Sony is innovative and believes in personal initiative, they wanted a program that was a hands-on learning experience.
Each player, as president of his or her own company, starts with $30,000 of venture capital and makes all the strategic, financial, manufacturing, marketing, sales, and management decisions for a period of 5 fiscal years.
The primary objective is to give a manager, no matter what his area of expertise is, a holistic view of how every aspect and every function of business must be synchronized and balanced for that company to run most efficiently, most effectively, and indeed most profitably. Oftentimes when we're a research and development person or a manufacturing person or a salesperson, we focus totally on our own goals. We have tunnel vision, it's occupational hazard. If we can focus on our goals in relation to corporate goals, we can work better and make a greater contribution to the corporation.
The Sony Management Simulation provides a rare opportunity for managers to broaden their horizons and experience the world of business as a whole. The spring of 85 has brought us exciting product introductions, successful trade shows, and press conferences. We look forward to reporting on more significant events in our next edition of In Sync, Sonam's video magazine.